section of the draw is concerned. Well, it's the top half of the draw. And, well, very difficult for us to see because our monitor here is all out of focus. We can't really see what was said there. The Indonesian players have already won two Super Series tournaments this year. Gideon Marcus Fernaldi and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumondo. Winners in Delhi at the India Super Series and then in Sydney at the Australian Super Series.
Red or blue?
Add to that a win at the Malaysian Grand Prix Gold earlier this year, so three titles to them.
Serve? Who serve first?
And as far as the English pair are concerned, we're trying to reach only a second ever Super Series quarterfinal. They've never been beyond a quarterfinal, but they do have an Olympic bronze medal.
Yes.
Gideon Marcus Fernaldi, sporting a very short haircut. Of course, he won a Super Series title playing with Marcus Kido, won as a qualifier. 2013 French Super Series. That was an extraordinary result of two. So it's number seven seeds from Indonesia. Up against the unseeded Marcus Ellis and Chris Langeridge. Whereas the English pair are concerned, well, became the first ever Olympic medalists in the men's doubles discipline in Rio. So there is Gideon Marcus Fernaldi, 25 years of age from Jakarta. And he and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumondo, he's just 21 years of age. And they're currently at a career high 7 in the world ranking. Enjoying their second week at a career high. First appearance here at this event as a pair. So in their first match, they beat Kim Jae Kwon and Yoo Young Sung, new combination. Of course, Yoo Young Sung's former doubles partner, Lee Yong Dae, has retired. And there you can see, very close second game, 23-21, had to save a game point at 19-20. So to Chris Langeridge, he's 31 years of age, born in Epsom in Surrey, lives in Milton Keynes. One of his big ambitions was to go to the Olympics. And he walked away with a bronze medal with this man, 27-year-old Marcus Ellis from Huddersfield. And they are currently at a career high as well of 16. Now they had a bye in their first match. Not quite sure why the non-seeded players had byes. Usually the seeds that have byes, isn't it? Anyway, this is the third meeting between these two pairs. Both previous meetings have been won by the Indonesians. Last time they met was in the first round of the Indonesia Super Series. Two straight games it was. 22-20, 21-15 in 43 minutes. Now, of course, at the Olympic Games, the English pair represent Great Britain. Well, they've never even been in a final of a Grand Prix event, let alone a Grand Prix Gold event, the English pair. And as I say, never yet further than a Super Series quarterfinal.
Ladies and gentlemen,
On my right. Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Alice, Marcus, Lanrich, Chris. And on my left, Gideon, Marcus, Fernandez. Sakamaju, Kevin, Sanyara. Sakamaju, Kanyara, to serve to Alice, Commerce. Love all, play.
Almost a scenic serve. Famous way of serving that was prohibited many years ago. Wow, the shuttle changes, completely tumbles over the net. What kind of serve is that?
Love.
Play.
Service over.
Great control by
3-1.
Kevin Sakamoto.
He's just about the quickest player, I think, on a men's doubles court. What do you reckon, Steve?
Yeah, I think so too.
Leg.
Well, why wasn't he ready?
The only challenger could be Zhang Siwei.
Broken strings.
Service over. 2-3.
Of course, I was talking when introducing these players, Steen, about so many of them being at career highs at the moment. Now that's been helped by the fact that all retired players have now been removed from the ranking list. So in men's doubles, there's three pairs or so that have, certainly women's doubles, there's three pairs that I think that were in the top 20 that have suddenly disappeared.
Yeah.
Ooh, service fault called. Struck above the waist. Oh, look at that defense. That's amazing.
Come on, go!
Service over. 5-4.
Yakupoi on the right as we looked at them. And James Boxall, the other. another English coach. The English pair got to do tactically here, Steen, do you think, if they want to win this one?
Yeah, I think that they should try to sort of build on their Olympic experience, where they had enormous success in being in control of the rallies. Marcus Ellis, he was working extremely hard on both mid-court and back-court, and Chris Langridge was controlling the net and sort of calling the shots for when it was a push or when it was a block and so on. Benefited a little bit from the conditions, in my opinion, the defense. I'm not sure that the defense is as solid as it looked at the Olympics, but here they have two players that are not very tall on the other side, so it won't be this steep attack, so I think maybe the defense could hold up in this match. The problem for the English side is that the two Indonesian players, they're so quick on their feet.
Oh, did that go over? It did go over.
Over. 6-8. 7-8.
chat.
Well, he does tend to annoy opponents, yeah. Doesn't he, when he has this sort of tomfoolery bit?
He does, and I mean, it's regardless of whether they're his own teammates or his opponents. I've seen them play Indonesian players, and they're really, really annoyed with him.
Yeah. Yeah, because he wasn't trying to hit that shuttle. No. He knew it was going out. It's the English pair who have the advantage at the mid-game interval, 2-point advantage.
Seem to be when we turn them. Code one, 20 seconds. The lift was off. The kidding is not doing anything right now.
So Jakubowy takes leave of the court after his advice there.
Good shot.
Oh, yes.
Well played. Yeah. Great rally.
He does have a good work ethic on court, doesn't he?
Fantastic. Ellis. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Works on tiles here.
Yeah, and I thought Chris Langridge during the Rio Olympic Games, I thought he was seeing the shuttle like a football, wasn't he? He seemed to see it so early at the net.
And talking about these post-Olympic blues, I don't know if there's any blues for this pair here, but I mean, the post-Olympics, they've perhaps the most unexpected medal winners in badminton, at least at this Olympics here. So, as you said in the beginning, Chris Langridge had a goal of going to the Olympics.
Yeah.
Now he won a medal.
Yeah.
And that's what everybody says, that, hey, I dream of a medal. Yeah, but this time your dream came true.
Yeah.
And I mean, so I had a little talk to him yesterday in the hotel and discussed this, that anything that comes along for the rest of his career is just benefits. So that's of course nice, but on the other hand, I think they might be out to prove themselves that it was actually a deserved medal, because they hadn't really done a lot ahead of this. As you say, they're only trying to get into the second quarterfinal of the Super Series, so try to feed off this self-confidence and joy 13. That the Olympic medal must have brought them.
Whoa.
13. That's a high service. from Gideon Finale. Wow. I really like that shot from Mark Zellis because there was no power in it. It was just steep.
Yeah. And he was really the forgotten man of English men's doubles, wasn't he, for a long time?
He was.
Mark Zellis.
Played some mixed with Gabby Adcock whilst Chris Adcock was playing with Imogen Bankia. But only got into the equation after Chris Adcock decided to focus solely on men's doubles.
Mm.
13-14.
I think actually, I don't know, but I think maybe that the team management had thought of this pair as the second pair, whilst Andy Ellis, who used to play with Chris Adcock, and Peter Mills was perhaps considered as the best prospect.
Yeah, he wants the court mopped. Gets his way.
Quite satisfied with the quality of the mopping.
Yeah, well, the perspiration on the court surface can become a little bit slippery, and the last thing we want or need is anybody slipping and picking up a nasty injury.
To see that service in slow motion and in a close up, it tumbles over the net. In my opinion, it might be perfectly legal. It's just a very, very good way he hits it.
Judgment.
18-14.
Six straight points. From 12-14 down.
That's problematic, I think, for Ellison Langridge. I think they'll have difficult times in catching up.
Yeah, and they're obviously, this serve you were talking about, with them chopping it. Now, what's going on here? She gonna give him a yellow card? What on earth for? Yeah, she's quite right. Serve, they are chopping under the base of the shuttle, and that's allowed. They should know that.
Coverage by him.
Service over. 19.
Gideon. Nailed it. Is when you play Kevin Tsukamoldo in men's doubles, you should always take half a step closer to the net, because when he has the smash opportunity, he's very, very often doing something else, something creative, and he often yells more than sort of the power of his smash
all part
calls
of the
for. Yeah.
Look at that. Did you see that? He was looking in completely the opposite direction from where he was hitting the shuttle. I mean, they're good value to watch, aren't they, the Indonesians?
They're fun to watch.
Quick. 21-16, opening game.
Gideon, Marcus Fernandez, Sakamuju, Kevin Sayara. 21-16.
Umpire confirms the score. 21-16 in 24 minutes. And when you consider they were 12-14 down. 9 of the next 11 points.
Whilst we're seeing the Indonesian coach in the picture, I could see English head coach Jakob Hoy talking to the umpire. Not satisfied with something. Probably the services of Kevin Tsukamoldo. I think there's two issues in it. I think from what we can see, he hits the cork first, so that's allowed. I'm not sure that he's hitting it below his waist, but that's a recurring discussion. Of course, all players, when they face another player who is serving well, will try to sort of take that advantage away from him or her by suggesting that it's in some possible way illegal or not correct.
He often uses that sort of crouch down movement, looking for the drive, and then counteracts it with an even faster shot, flat back over the net.
And that's exactly why the English pair should be very careful when they push in the flat game. They should be totally certain that they're in a good position so that they can't get counterattacked.
Yeah.
But
well played from Gideon Marcus Vinaldi. My little chuckle in the middle of that rally, though, was the backhand topspin defensive disguise shot from Sulca Muljo. First time I ever saw him play, you know, he was playing a mixed doubles, came through the qualifying in Jakarta. Were you there? Indonesian Open.
And no, I think it was the year before.
Very first round, they beat the then Olympic champions, Jiang Nang and Xiao Yunlei.
Yeah.
It was extraordinary. And I don't really think of Gracia Poli as a mixed doubles player.
His playing style is so special to most other players that it takes some time to get used to it.
Mm. Kevin, come here. I couldn't really hear that, I'm afraid. Oh my goodness me. That's unbelievable. Very, very rarely in men's doubles do you see players being left stranded. Well, the English players were in that rally. Warning for misconduct. On who? I think the yellow card was given to Chris Langridge, but I'm really not certain.
I think it was given to Marcus Ellis, and I definitely doesn't like that, because he actually went to the umpire and talking to her.
Yeah.
So, yeah, let's hope she met Chris Langridge.
Did she say 6-3?
Yeah, it's 7-3.
It's 7-3. Well, our internet's gone down. Oh no, she's corrected herself. Monitor wasn't working a moment ago. We were running blind, weren't we?
Yeah.
All's well that ends well. There it is again. Oh. We didn't hit one single smash in that rally, did he?
Yeah.
You're right about taking a step forward.
He handles the situation great, Kevin Tsukamoto here.
Smash with full pirouette in the middle of that. How do you catch this one, Steen? Look at this. Look at that.
Yeah.
I love it. I love it.
Play.
Do you demonstrate that one?
Tried it once and they were just able to put a piece of paper between my feet and the floor.
Well, at least you left the floor. I don't think I ever did. What a great serve.
10-4.
Well, English players don't like it because it's not called. We need to see that again. No, we really need to see it again.
This is ridiculous. There's no rules, is there?
Now the players are discussing it across the net. Well, once again, perhaps not the most experienced umpire, because she really needs to take control of this.
But I can see what the English player is complaining about, and that is that the left arm goes up in the service movement.
Well, I'd really like to see it again.
Yeah.
37 minutes into the match. No, not much instruction from the Indonesian coach. Haryono Miranat. I think Yakupoi, as much as anything, needs to try and calm his men down.
Yeah, and I mean, sometimes it also takes the focus away from one thing, and that is that this Indonesian pair is playing great men's doubles.
Yeah. It's a mountain to climb for the Olympic medalists right now, isn't it? Between the legs there from Chris Langridge. Oh yeah. Disguised drop shot of his own. Nice.
Service fault called on Marcus Ellis now. And that more or less ends this match.
Yeah. Ago, Simon Nagel was very outspoken after playing here in China about some of the court officials.
16-6.
Zina Nawal, incidentally, wonderful to see her back on court, made her comeback here yesterday after knee surgery, but sadly for her, lost.
Yeah, three games.
Mm. Former champion here, of course, isn't she? The title 2 years ago and then lost in the final last year, so I don't know. Yeah, it's a good judgment call from Chris Langridge to his partner to leave it.
Saw a big comeback from Zhang Bowen in the previous match, but I still think this is garbage time we're watching now, meaning that there's some rallies going on, but I have a feeling that the match is decided in favor of the Indonesians.
Mm-hmm. Well, they're only 2 points away now. Look at that. Right, he did unleash one. Host of match point opportunities.
Pointing to the service judge and saying that they find it quite curious that it's at match point that he calls the first service fault.
Okay.
That's wild. So two straight games for the number seven seeds, Gideon Marcus Finaldi and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumoljo. 21-16, 21-13, 46 minutes needed. Well, it all went a little flat in that second game, didn't it, Steen? We were so looking forward to that men's doubles, but...
They dominated the second game. The Indonesians deserved victory.
Yeah. So our next match is mixed doubles, and it's more Olympic medalists. In fact, three of the four players on court have been in an Olympic final. It's mixed doubles. It's the number three seeds, Chan Peng Soon and Goh Liu Ying of Malaysia, against Jiang Dang and Li Yunhui.